words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, Lord, my strength and my redeemer. We aren't called to shine our own light, but to reflect the light of the living Jesus Christ. This is the testimony of me, Carolyn McGrew, and Jim McGrew, because I drag him everywhere. Our story starts early in 2000s. We lived in a beautiful house at Eagle Point Circle. We were up 14 and a half feet, built to Camille's specifications. We decided that we were going to retire. We needed a motor home. We found it in Laurel after much searching, and it had belonged to a friend of Jim's uncle. We also had decided that as we aged, we couldn't continue to go up and down the stairs and muck up after a storm. By a miraculous happenstance, we found property out on John Clark Road about a 5 minutes from our daughter's house. So we progressed then to the summer of 2005. I retired from the TV station. We packed that motor home, ready to go on our many, many travels all around the country. Then as my birthday approached and Labor Day, the storm was out in the Gulf. So, on that Saturday, Joy and Lucas and Ed, wherever they are, we moved everything upstairs and headed out. Little did we know that that was the change in our lives. When we were able to get back in, we literally lay figuratively in the mud. There was nothing left. Remember, we built to Camille's specs. There was nothing left but piles and clothes hanging out of the trees. Now, Jim McGrew and I are pretty strong people. We spent 20 years in the Air Force. Jim flew transports. He was a navigator. He was in and out of the war zone, in and out of Vietnam. People shooting at him all the time. He also did almost a year in an isolated place in Thailand, called Nakhon Phanom, flying EC-47s, which, to our understanding, are spy planes. So we're pretty strong. We have a strong marriage. We have a strong faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. And we were buckled to the knees because everything was gone but what we had in that murder home that the good Lord had provided for us. We didn't know what to do. We held hands and we said, Lord, this is it. You have got to help us. Please take this from us. And he did. And he did. And he did. We had a place to live. With Jim's asthma, we had never been able to stay in a FEMA trailer. We had a motor home to live in. We got an SBA loan in something like 10 days, which is miraculous. Then two angels on earth named Ronnie and Little CM Plummer built us a house out on that property at John Clark Road. A custom built house. Someone bought the motor home. Someone bought the lot at Eagle Point. The government gave us a grant. The insurance company settled with us. And I stand today to tell you, thanks to Almighty God for all that he did in our lives, because all of that was because of him. Because we gave it up to him. Today, we have more stuff than we've ever had before. We have a stronger relationship with each other and a much stronger relationship with the living God. We thank him every day for every blessing we have. And I say to you from the bottom of my heart, I sincerely hope that you never have to face a hurricane. Never. But any storm in your life, however it may be, Turn it over to God. Ask Him to take it from you. And He will, because He is a loving and caring God. We stand as testimony to His love and His care.
Well, little did I know that he had which we will all later, instead one of my responsibilities was to be director of Vacation Bible School. So I was like in complete panic mode, and I told him, no, I can't do that. You know, leading a small youth group is one thing, but this was a whole different ball game for me. But he reminded me that I could do all things through Christ who strengthened me. And he said there were people that would help me. And actually, it's weird today that one of my former youth is here, but also Joy and Lucas, and that's here. And Joy helped me that first year, and she was a big help to me. So I just thank God that he sent me to help me. I did that first Vacation Bible School carrying Beth around on my hip. So that's been a while back. But through that, I discovered that God had given me a passion for taking those Bible stories that I had read in those blue Bible story books and make them come alive and interesting for children. So that was over 20 years ago, and I still have that passion for Sunday school and for Vacation Bible School to make that Bible come alive for children. So God can help you do things that you don't think you can do. And he's covered me with grace so many times. And being in any type of ministry is not easy. It can be really hard. And my life has been blessed, but it's not been easy. And I've been through a roller coaster of ups and downs. You know, I went through a bad divorce, a struggle as a single mom for 4 years, but the God of all my days was with me. Donald came as youth director when we married in 2001. And then he decided to step down not long after that. And it went about a year for different people doing it. But one day when I was working, I heard the voice of God so clear in my heart and mind as if he was standing next to me. And he said, it's time to go back to the youth ministry. So I went home and I told Don, and I said, we need to do this together. So we approached the pastor at the time. And I don't know why. I can't remember the reasons, but he said, no. And I was so confused. I'm like, okay, I know I heard God really clear, but he just said no. So I thought, okay. So a couple of weeks later, he came and he said, I want y'all to do this. So I don't know why the delay was there, but God does. So we took it, and we were, and I love getting back in youth ministry. A few years ago, Don asked me to step down as part of the leadership, but he continues to help me on a whole lot behind the scenes, the rest of my family. The Lord has blessed me through the years with so much grace. You know, it's just been really hard sometimes. I've had a lot of struggles that's been true test to my faith. I struggled with infertility, divorce. My mom almost got killed in an accident. I had to spend months caring for her. My fireman nephew almost died in a really bad fire. And then a few months later, his brother, a police officer, my nephew, committed suicide. Right behind that, Katrina almost completely destroyed our home. And like Carolyn said, my faith was shaken. And to be honest, I went down into a really dark pit. But even though I couldn't feel God's presence, I cried out to him. And because he's the God of all my days, he did not let the despair ruin my life. He brought me up out of it, and he covered me with a grace that brought me through it and made me stronger. Through the years, he sent me help with the youth ministry, wonderful help. And without them, it would have been really hard. Becky came to the church right after the storm. It was a blessing. She's been behind the scenes with me for many years now. Other adults have gone on trips with us, prepared food, drove the bus, just helped make it plain fun. And my greatest joy is just to have those people around me, and especially my two children, who have the privilege to see me grow up, be active in this church, and work by my side in the youth ministry. And they have a love for the Lord in this church. You know, the blessings, like I said, far outweigh the heartaches. When I get discouraged, I remember these scriptures that the Lord gave me one day, and I was really upset over a youth that had went down the wrong path. And when you've been in youth ministry for a lot of years, you see that. You have a lot of blessings that you see these kids do the right thing and make the right choices. But there's always those few that don't. And you pray and hope that someday they'll come back to it. But I really beat myself up for a long time about that. I feel like I did it personally, that I had failed. But when I felt like that, God gave me Isaiah 55:10-11. For as the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return there until they water the earth, making it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word that goes out from my mouth, it shall not return empty, but will accomplish that which I purpose and succeed in the thing for which I sent it. And also 2 Corinthians 9:10. He who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will supply and multiply your seed for sowing and increase the harvest of your righteousness. And that was a reminder that all I have to be is obedient to plant the seeds, that I'm to put them in the Lord's hands. be their savior. I can only point them to Jesus. Just be faithful and leave the outcome to God. And that took a load of burdens on my shoulder that I could just do what I'm supposed to do and let him do the rest. And you know, God is calling each and every one of us to do something for his kingdom. It doesn't matter if it's little or big or somewhere in between. We all are called and we're all supposed to do something. So I challenge you to pray and ask him, what am I supposed to be doing if you don't already know what you're supposed to be doing? You don't have to be afraid because he'll show you every step of the way just as he's shown me. It's not easy, but with the peace and joy that comes from doing exactly what God is asking you to do, it's beyond anything else in this earth. So if God can use a shy, red-headed country bumpkin like me, he can use anybody. He's only asking us to be faithful, to trust him, and be willing to be used. Even though the seasons in our life change, as mine has many, many times, he will always remain the God of our days. May God bless you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Barbara Jones, and my husband Don and I attend first service on the first Sunday of the month, and the rest of the Sundays we go to second service. My sharing with you this morning is not about me. It's about him. Not at all. I knew I had not prepared for that. I did not take college preparatory classes, and I just didn't think that would work for me. But I went. I made it despite the lack of money, preparation, and confidence. Now, who did that? God did. That part of my life proved that Jeremiah 29:11 is true. He had a plan for me, and he has a plan for you. Every one of you, no matter what age, still, he has a plan for you. My degree was in elementary education. And this also proved that Philippians 4:13 is true. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. God does much more than just answer a simple prayer. It's unreal how much and unbelievable how much he can go with that simple answering that prayer, because there was a ripple effect. My dream of spreading the good news of Jesus came true in the classroom. That became a mission. My grandmother was right. And did you notice that doors were closed to my ideas? But God had another plan. My stepdad taught me the love of planting seeds, and my heavenly father taught me to spread a different kind of seed, the seeds of acceptance, patience, joy, love, gentleness, confidence, and many others. But the greatest seed of all that any of us could plant is the seed, the source of love, is Jesus. I called my classroom my garden, and my students were my flowers. Each one of us remained unique and special and beautiful in his eyes, and he can use each one of us in different ways. The flowers bloom in their own season at different times, just like we do, like children do. And we do that in our own walk and journey. We pray and we do the right things and attempt and all, but God has his timing of when the depth will come in our walk. I encourage you to read the church newsletter. Brother Lynn has always had a message there that blesses and helps. And the different ministries here at Coville also have articles in the newsletter that are blessings to you too, and it has information. Our prayer ministry speaks to your heart about prayer. Read those articles. You are encouraged to have a little talk with Jesus every day in the morning before you even start to function. Have a little talk with Jesus, because as Brother Lynn says, we never know what is ahead of us for the day. So get yourself prepared for whatever he has. And read his word and believe it. And in your prayer time with Jesus, you will discover God's plan for your life, no matter what your age. You will grow in your faith and trust, and a deeper relationship with the one and only, who will always be with you and bless you. God has a perfect plan. He will give you confidence to see that plan through, and he will bless it. Now, I'd like for you to come into his presence in prayer. Lord, as we come before you, we want to thank you for each person here today. May each one come to you every day in prayer. May they know what your plan is for their life. May they come to know all of the things that are possible.